Symbols, icons are all around us. They surround you and me in our day-to-day lives, whether it is in our logos, our texting, and of course, our comics. We are, according to Scott McCloud, living in a true symbol-oriented culture. We will use his definition of both symbols and icons. Icons, any image used to represent a person, place, thing, or ID. The crucial difference between an icon and a symbol is that the latter represents ideas, while icons are pictorial representations of items that are visible. In this video, we will therefore focus on symbols, more specifically the convention of the spiral, and study how they are able to instantly convey meanings, sensations, as well as emotions more effectively than words. In order to arrive at that final conclusion, we must before analyze the creation and evolution of symbols to understand how they successfully become part of the common language. We will also try to understand why this notion is key to comic books. Spirals are omnipresent in animals, in nature. Its natural formation evokes the evolution of a force, a state. The Maya's earliest civilizations would even use its pattern for cosmology. The spiral was, therefore, in the earliest period of recorded civilizations, an already pretty well established visual metaphor as stated by the drawings and carvings found in many different countries. This is good because according to McCloud, the longer a symbol exists, the more it is subjected to change. This sentence makes us wonder, ultimately, has the original signification of the spiral remained when we are confronted to this, one of the panels from Scott McCloud's Understanding Comics? Probably no, at least not for me. A symbol following McCloud's definition can be taken out of context and be applied anywhere, where the reader will instantly grasp the information. If we would narrow the spiral to its original essence, then it could not be considered an effective symbol. There comes the importance of both its evolution and its entrance within the common language. So, let's talk about the spiral's evolution. We have to go back to the 18th century. At that time, hypnotic techniques became more prominent in the West after researchers explored the Middle East. The Austrian physician Dr. Franz Anton Mesmer's studies on altered consciousness led him to use objects with the intent of inducing his patients in trance-like states. However, it was one of his disciples that is credited with being the first to use the hypnotic spiral in the West. The results were not that good, but we're not interested in that. The image of hypnotic spiral, on the other hand, remained and became popular as film and TV industry introduced it to large audiences. This is where step two comes in. In 1958, the film Vertigo, directed by Alfred Hitchcock, found huge success within audiences. In it, the director uses spirals throughout the movie as soon as the opening title sequence. The spirals come to represent a dizzying and unsteady distortion of reality, the presence of danger and chaos. A year later, in 1959, in what will last until 1966, the TV show The Twilight Zone premiered. Of course, as soon as The Twilight Zone is mentioned, the first thing that pops into our mind is the music. In the swiveling spiral, we establish again a new connotation, this time adding the meaning of a portal towards another dimension, world, and reality. Like this, the spiral became a widely known symbol within the pop culture. It is compelling to see that these two very influential pieces of work came just before the hippie movement in the 60s. The hippie movement is one relatively known for its abundant use of psychedelic drugs, and the trips that resulted from this consumption could be compared to the trance state of hypnosis. We could thereby suggest or at least propose a theory that the symbol of the spiral being so recently introduced into the people's consciousness, being so fresh in the people's mind, that it was rapidly associated to the use of drugs. Once the spiral found its place in popular works, more artists were influenced and therefore reused it. The repetition caused by this artistic robbery is what introduces a symbol into the common language. Finally, now that we understand the process by which a symbol becomes part of the language, we must answer the following question. Why is this so important for the world of comics? Well, symbols have the capacity to trigger a physiological response in a much more effective way than words or even characters. For instance, in the panel from Understanding Comics, the spirals instantly activate knowledge that we gain throughout many experiences. With only one line going in a circular motion, the symbol of the spiral describes the invisible. Therefore, a symbol, in order to be part of the language, must be used enough times, no matter the medium, so as to enter the common consciousness. Once it has, all the meanings attached to it come out automatically, benefiting the comic industry, known for its concise and effective nature.